Christmas time. There's no need to be afraid. All right, welcome everybody. It is the Conway and Whitman Show, and we are live on 97.1 Free FM. Tim Conway Jr. and Brian David Whitman, man. Nice
Timmy,
to see you, dude.
Look at you, man.
Yeah.
I've been waiting for that song for a month, and Jerry and Randy got it. Do they know it's Christmas?
Oh, that's right. It makes you emotional, right?
No. This is one of my favorite Christmas songs. Oh. The Christmas song that makes me cry is...
Jingle Bells?
No. Is Where Are You Christmas by Faith Hill.
Oh.
Yeah, that. If you listen to the lyrics of that, I mean, I bet you'd cry, too.
Is that right?
Yeah. But this is a great
song.
Bring
in the tissues and the song.
Do you remember this when you were in, like, this song reminds me of probably the eighth grade.
So I was probably in college.
Gosh, is there that much of a difference?
It was 10 years.
Yeah.
You're 35?
Yes, I am, sir.
I'll be 45 come October.
Come October, man. God almighty. Yeah, come October, I'll be 45, man. Yeah, I know when your birthday is. Come October, man.
Just turn 44, man.
Tim, there won't be snow in Africa this Christmas.
It might be in South Africa.
Well, that's possible. It's a different climate there.
No, North Africa.
Crank it up, Jerry. Greatest gift there.
We got breaking news here, ladies and gentlemen.
Whoa.
Breaking news. Here it is. Less than an hour old. It's hot off the press.
This is breaking news.
Turns out Spears is pregnant.
Britney Spears?
No.
It's Christmas, bitch.
Jamie Lynn Spears.
Oh, the sister?
Her 16-year-old sister.
Oh, no.
Jamie Lynn Spears says she's pregnant. Another Spears baby is reportedly on the way. Thank God.
Oh, no.
And it's not Britney's. It's Jamie Lynn Spears, the 16-year-old Zoe 101 star and sister of Britney, told OK Magazine. That's sort of an odd name for a magazine.
Yeah, you know, I think that's becoming popular, though.
Is that a great magazine?
Well, I think
that's OK.
I think it's become popular with chicks, OK Magazine. I'm seeing it a lot now.
Is that right?
When you leave the supermarket. It's like right up there now with the People magazine. And
but shouldn't this be in It's Not Okay magazine that the 16-year-old's pregnant?
This is actually in a monthly journal called It's Socially Inappropriate.
Let me see. She's pregnant, and the father is...
Do we know? Because that's positive if we do.
Malibu Dan.
All right.
No, Casey Aldridge.
I don't know who that is.
I don't either. It was a shock for both of us. So unexpected, she said. I was in complete and total shock.
Now, at 16, is this her first child, Tim?
Her third. She had one when she was 6, and she had another one when she was 10 and a half.
Oh, all right. So she's a... She's,
this is her third kid.
This is old hat for her.
Yeah.
Get your freaking act together here!
Yeah, she has a 10-year-old kid, a 6-year-old kid, mm-hmm. or a 5-year-old kid.
And a fetus now.
And now she's got a fetus, yeah. Spears is 12 weeks along. And initially kept the news to herself when she learned of her pregnancy from an at-home test and subsequent doctor visit.
Oh.
She told the Celebrity magazine, which hits newsstands in New York on Wednesday and the rest of the country by Friday.
Whoa. But you know what this is all about, Conway, here at Christmas time and the celebration of the holidays? It reminds me once again of role models.
Yeah. Who's her role model?
Her role model is her effed up older sister, Britney.
Yeah. I guess
now, how
so,
many
huh?
how many kids does Britney have? Just the two, right?
No, she's got 6.
No, get out of here. Gina knows the answer. Britney Spears has just 2 children, right?
Jaden James and
Preston.
Elvis
James,
or something.
Elvis
yeah.
Preston.
No, Preston.
Right. But she's pregnant too, isn't she?
Britney?
It's alleged that she is pregnant and she's already sent her sonogram to 5 people.
Oh, that's pretty cool. Oh, maybe they can have the baby around the same time.
Well, their sister is pregnant at the same time. That's kind of sweet. I guess they'll bond. I'm trying to make this sound good, you know, but this is bad.
Well, what message does she want to send to the other teens about premarital sex? Here's a quote. I definitely don't think it's something you should do. It's better to wait.
Is she showing while she says that?
Yeah, she's rubbing her pregnant stomach while she's saying that. But I can't be judgmental because it's a position I put myself in. After she found out from a doctor that she was pregnant, she said, I took 2 weeks to myself and didn't tell anybody.
Okay.
Only one of my friends knew.
I would assume that would be the father knew, I would think.
I don't even think the father knew.
Okay.
But only one of my friends knew because I needed to work out what I would do with myself before I let anyone's opinion affect my decision.
Stupid bitch.
Okay, so she obviously thought about maybe not having the child.
Yeah.
Okay, all right.
Then I told my parents and my friends. I was scared, but I had to do what was right for me.
Okay, well, the decision is obviously...
Seems mature. Mature decision.
It seems like she certainly went through the... in a mature way, went through the thought process. I mean, either decision... is hers to make. I'm not going to judge the decision. I mean,
I am.
Okay. You're going to judge it and say she made the right decision.
She made the wrong decision to get pregnant at 16.
Oh, okay.
Spears broke the news to her mother, Lynn, who's got to be very proud of her child and her child's child.
Last few years, Lynn must be on cloud nine.
Oh, yeah. She's raised some beauties. Is Lynn Spears... the devil?
No, I do not. I do not think so. No,
you don't think she is
actually Satan,
right?
I believe she's not.
All right. Just before Thanksgiving, she told her mom. The magazine reported she was very upset because it wasn't what she expected at all. Lynn Spears said,
"Right, Lynn probably expected past the turkey."
Right. A week after, she had time to cope with it and became very supportive. All right. Well, in a week, she went from "I can't believe my crazy, effed up 16-year-old kid" to, "Well, let's go crib shopping."
I guess you have to. I mean, at some point, if you're going to be a supportive parent, you have to get over that initial shock and that anger and try to, I don't want to tell people what to do. I shouldn't. I don't seek to tell people what to do. But I guess at some point, a lot of parents do get over that initial anger and then become kind of a partner in it if their kid is underage.
But, you know, I'd like to take the part of my mind, of my brain that is consumed with the Spears situation.
Yes, the
and
lobe.
And remove that.
That you have that lobe removed?
Yeah. Because the Spears have taken up a lot of my time.
Yeah, we know them well.
Yeah, I know more about Britney Spears and now Jamie Lynn Spears than I do about some of my cousins.
Right, right.
That's true.
Well, I understand that's true. Yeah, they're in our lives. I mean, they're a couple
I know more about Britney Spears than I know about my Uncle Jack Dalton.
Britney Spears, Lindsay Lohan, Paris Hilton, these are chicks. These chicks are in our lives. I mean, it's almost like we're dating these chicks.
But it's almost like we're in the perfect storm because we've been tortured by Britney Spears for quite some time.
Right.
And now that that's sort of dying down.
Yeah, she's handing it off almost.
Another storm. Another Spears storm is brewing.
Right. Another Spears comes along to pick up the baton.
Right. And then we're going to be tortured by this one for a while. And then we're going to be tortured by the baby Spears.
Right. Well, the seed.
Britney's two kids and now Jamie Lynn's kid.
You know who actually stayed in, decent shape? And I'm happy to want to shine a spotlight and maybe even applaud for two celebrity sisters that have managed to hold it together. Jessica Simpson and Ashley Simpson.
I don't know. Jessica Simpson, I believe, has fallen apart.
Has she?
Oh. Yeah, she's in and out of relationships. She doesn't seem very happy.
Now, I have a question for you. You are a dad.
Yes.
You're a young father. Your baby is 2 years and 2 months old.
Right.
Soon, come October, man. 3 years old.
Right.
Come October. So with the experience you have as a dad, would you, as a father, forget about being, forget about being Tim Conway's son for a second.
Thank you. It's tough to do, but thanks.
As a father,
right.
Would you recommend to a 16-year-old girl this lifestyle, this course of action? Because you know what it's about. I mean, you know what having a kid is
like. It's a lot of work. And when you're 16, this chick might have the money to raise a child. But she certainly doesn't have the time. I mean, she's involved in a television show, plus she's going to school. How much time is going to be given to the kid?
Right. You think this might be one of those cases where, like, the mom of the mom?
They'll hand her off to somebody.
Right.
Somebody will raise that kid. But that poor kid, man, that kid has no shot.
Well, I don't say that. I mean,
really
I
really doesn't.
I hate to say that.
Lynn Spears, already grandmother to Britney's young sons, told the magazine, "I didn't believe it because Jamie Lynn's always been conscientious. She's never late for a curfew. I was in shock."
Yeah, she's never late for. She has a curfew.
How about that? I was in shock. She's the mother of Britney Spears, and she's shocked.
Right.
That her crazy sister's pregnant now.
Right. Yeah. So, do you think the head shaving shocked her as well?
Shocked.
I'm shocked.
Yeah. Let's spare shock, baby. I don't think you can experience shock anymore.
No, she's been shocked probably to a point of probably to the point of numbness.
Yeah, we're shocked as to what a crazy mother you are. All right, the United States of America is shocked.
Right, let us be shocked if it's all right.
Yeah, we're shocked with you, and we're shocked with your kids. All right,
we're the shocked ones in this group.
We're all filled with shock. You, no shock.
Us,
it's so amazing that she said, "I'm shocked." Jesus Christ.
Well,
you know, I heard this news today, and I wasn't.
Well, you know, but maybe she expects, in fairness to Lynn Spears, the mother of Britney Spears and Jamie Lynn Spears, maybe, Jamie Lynn is her name, right?
Jamie Lynn, yeah.
Yeah, so she has her mom's middle name, I guess. Her middle name is her mom's first name. I would expect, if you were to tell me, Spears is pregnant, I didn't even know
there was a younger Spears.
Oh, I did. I knew she had a younger sister, but I would never have guessed that the younger sister would be the pregnant one. I thought that all of that behavior was kind of reserved for Britney. I thought that was kind of her area. And I thought the younger sister was actually kind of running a decent life.
I thought she was running away from the craziness.
Yeah, and I don't want to say that making the decision to have a child at 16 is indecent. I don't want to be that judgmental. I'm not.
Well, then let me do it. It is. It's really bad parenting.
Oh, all right. Well, I don't, you know, with Christmas here, I don't want to, you know, say that she's an indecent person, because some people would say that she's made the decent decision. Some would say that it would be indecent to decide not to have the baby.
Dirty bitch!
Nah, she should have had
an abortion.
An abortion. Uh-huh. And Jamie or Lynn Spears.
The mom.
The mom should have had a very, very late abortion. And abort her two kids. Then we would all enjoy ourselves again.
Well, we'd certainly have time to talk about other things.
But we'd
be denied the great music and the great talents of the Spears girls.
It's Christmas, bitch.
Let's see here. It says, if this is possible, and again, only the Spears could pull this off.
Sure.
But if this is possible, I think that Lynn or Britney is capable of this. That when Britney's baby is born, if Britney is indeed pregnant, or now this 16-year-old Jamie Lynn Spears is pregnant.
Right.
I think those are the only two girls on the planet who could possibly have a baby and the baby's born pregnant. I think these are the only two chicks that could pull that off.
Well, that would be certainly the next big story, Tim.
Wouldn't that be a story? That Jamie Lynn's kid at birth is 2 weeks pregnant?
Forget OK Magazine. That'd be on CNN, wouldn't it?
That'd be somebody.
That'd be on 60 Minutes,
Mike. Believe It or Not.
They'd move the Spears family into the auditorium there in Hollywood.
She said her actor's daughter... The star of the series, Nickelodeon series, has known Aldridge, Casey Aldridge, for years.
Yeah, we got to find out about Pops here. Now, I want to find out about this dude. Is he a young guy? I mean, is he 16 too? I mean, what's his deal?
Well, this is odd. She said that she's known Aldridge for years and began dating him in high school. Sweetheart, you're in high school. It's like saying, I began dating him in December of 2007.
It is December.
It is December.
Of 2007, baby.
In a recent interview with the Associated Press, Spears said that she had no steady boyfriend, though. Quote, I kind of keep my options open.
Oh, well, not anymore. I mean,
those options are closing.
She better get to know Casey pretty well because he's the... Now, what does he do? Gina, do you know what he does? I mean,
is he an actor?
Is he an actor? Is he in the show with her?
I looked him up, and I couldn't find much on him.
Yeah, unfortunately, I'm not sure.
Yeah, I don't know what that dude does.
I'm going to have to
Google it.
She says here she wants to keep her options open, and I have a bunch of friends that I always hang out with. A bunch of guy friends.
Oh, boy. This
she declined to talk about her older sister. I wonder why.
She's a whore.
Spears spoke to the AP shortly before Thanksgiving. The day she told OK Magazine, she informed her mother about the pregnancy. All right. Here it is. Jamie Lynn plans to raise the baby in her home state of...
California.
Louisiana.
Oh, swing it a bus track one.
Where she will be one of the older... kids to have another child this year.
Right, where all the other parents will be coming to her for mommy advice.
Because she'll be one of the more...
Yeah, if you're in Louisiana and you're not pregnant by nine, they start giving you like old maid references.
My friend, how are you spelling Casey Aldridge's name? I want to try to find out about
it. Let's see. Aldridge. If you're 9 years old and you live in Louisiana and you're not pregnant... They kind of give you the eye like, oh, so you are you having problems? Is it you or him that can't get it going?
Well, now here's a story. I just clicked on Casey Aldridge, and it says that Britney Spears warned her sister Jamie Lynn against moving in with her boyfriend Casey Aldridge.
I saw that, but I don't get much information on Casey Aldridge. I don't know who the guy is, and I don't know how old he is either. I mean, if he's 18 or 19. There could be legal issues, no?
He is the son of a Tennessee paper mill worker.
Uh-oh.
That is according to this report from Reuters.
All right. Let's see. Jamie Lynn plans to raise the baby in Louisiana so it can have a normal family life. Darling, that ship has sailed. Nickelodeon released a statement.
Oh, boy.
They're not happy about it.
Yeah, well, they're the network for kids.
Here we go. And they've got to be very careful to be supportive yet not condone what she's doing.
That's right. They really have to straddle the fence, and you'll hear that in this statement.
Here it is. We respect Jamie Lynn's decision to take responsibility in this sensitive and personal situation. We know this is a very difficult time for her and her family.
All right.
And our primary concern right now is for Jamie Lynn's well-being. This is not a network that is celebrating this woman's pregnancy.
No, they're not. I don't think they're throwing a baby shower.
And, you know, first of all, wasn't it Disney that took some heat with High School Musical? Was it High School Musical?
Yes,
too?
High School Musical. Well, because...
With the nude pictures?
Right. I don't know that they took a lot of heat, but there was the one girl from High School Musical who was really hot, but apparently not the hottest girl on that show.
But see, you know, these big companies like Disney and, you know, Nickelodeon, which I believe is part of CBS.
Yeah.
They're not into this kind of crap. They run a very... clean, squeaky image for kids.
Yeah, of course.
And they don't want Britney Spears and now Jamie Lynn Spears showing up at Disneyland with that kid. And it's like, oh, isn't she from High School Musical? Hey, where are the nude pictures of her in a High School Musical? Or where is Jamie Lynn and her baby? Oh,
right.
Look at that. They're getting on the Matterhorn.
Well, maybe
they don't like it.
They might be able to. By the way, here's Casey. Now, I'm looking at this picture. I think that's him. Could be.
Older?
I'm not going to say because I don't know, but he certainly looks older than she is, right? Doesn't he look older than 16?
He looks a little older, yeah. He could be just a big 16-year-old kid.
A big goofy teenager. Sleeping with Britney Spears' sister.
Oh, man. I don't know. I mean, you know, if you live overseas and, you know, you come to this country and you're like, wow, Britney Spears, what happened to her? She used to be a very popular singer. Now she's bald and... You can see her crotch.
Right. She looks like Sinead O'Connor.
She gets out of cars.
She's doing strange things.
Yeah. She's hitting her ex-husband's car with an umbrella. She lost her kids. And then you look at her sister. Her sister's 16 and pregnant. You just have to think to yourself, what happened in this country? Why is this going on? These girls... are privileged beyond your wildest imagination.
Right. But this does prove what the Spears...
And they still can't get it together.
Well, if it's Britney Spears or, in this case, Jamie Lynn Spears or Lindsay Lohan, what all of these chicks prove, Tim, is that money, celebrity, and fame does not make you a member of a higher social class.
Yeah, it's like Michael Vick.
You know what I'm saying? Right. Michael Vick is a great example, too.
Thank you.
He got all the money in the world and all of the celebrity and fame in the world to live the high life.
And he's with those doggies.
And he's doing unspeakable things to these animals. And we've got, in the case of Britney Spears, erratic kind of white trash behavior, forgive me for lack of a better term. And I'm not referring to her pregnancies. I'm referring to the head shaving and the tattooing and all of that. And now we've got Jamie Lynn Spears. She could.
Hasn't she learned anything from her sister?
This is what I'm saying. She could be on this TV show. She could go to a fine college if she has half a brain. Certainly there's money for tuition. She could have a whole different life going. So money and fame, it's like with lottery winners. You know what I mean? If you give white trash $10 million, You didn't buy the white trash out of them. You know what I mean?
Right. Well, some people do.
Not really.
Zoe 101 is scheduled to conclude its third season January 4th with a cliffhanger episode in which Spears' character must decide whether to leave her fictional Pacific Coast Academy boarding school in California and join her parents in London.
Oh, well. Is that the cliffhanger episode?
I don't know. I don't even know what that show is.
Hey, guys, this kid's 19, by the way, the boy I found online.
He is.
And they met at church.
All right. Very good. All right, so the Casey Aldridge is 19.
Reportedly. I mean, we don't know. I don't have a birth certificate in front of me, but no.
Yeah, I guess one of the callers called up and said, yeah, they think that he's 19.
And she
now, doesn't
is,
that bring up legal issues?
Well, this is why I was saying.
I mean, isn't that guy now going to prison?
She's 16?
She's 16.
Okay.
He's 19.
Well, if that's true, and we've now had a number of calls suggesting that if that is true, I would think that that's a problem.
Yeah.
Right?
Jamie Lynn's child might be born with her father in prison for rape.
Jerry,
isn't that right?
Well,
that's what they call it.
Well, it is rape. The law views it as rape because Jamie Lynn Spears at 16 is under the age of consent.
Right.
Which is 18, I believe.
All right. I'm sure Nickelodeon is very thrilled.
I'm sure they're working this out as we speak.
All right, gang. White trash behavior. Can you beat this? 520-9710 and 888-520-9710. It is always fun to talk about white trash behavior around the holidays.
Well, it really is. You know,
there's never, ever a shortage of it in this country.
There's a warmth to it. You know?
I bet there's so many races other than white people right now that are just going, oh, at least it's not us today. 520-9710 and 888-520-9710. Your white trash behavior, man.
Yeah, all the other races, you take a powder. You get the day off today. Nothing about any other groups, gays, Asians, black people, Hispanic people. The whites are taking
white
it tonight.
White trash.
White trash is taking it tonight.
520-9710. It is the Conway and Whitman Show. Britney Spears' younger sister, Jamie Lynn Spears, 16, pregnant by a 19-year-old kid. Merry Christmas, everybody. It's Conway and Whitman live on 97.1 Free FM.
It's Christmas, bitch. Last night I took a walk in the snow. Couples holding hands, places don't go.
All right, welcome back, everybody. It is the Conway and Whitman Show. We're live at 97.1 Free FM. Another Spears is pregnant. Jamie Lynn Spears, 16, is pregnant by Casey Aldridge. And we've not confirmed this, but we understand from at least the internet that he might be 19 years old.
Right, that's Britney's younger sister. So the person we just heard singing was Aunt Britney.
Aunt Britney. Monica in Santa Monica. You're on 97.1 Free FM.
How are you?
Hi, there. I'm good, thanks. Listen, I was telling your screener that I come from a country, and I remember growing up, if I would say something bad to my parents, they would slap me. And I do agree with you that it's all about parenting.
Right.
These kids, since they're little, there's nothing there.
You're absolutely right. Where are you from?
I'm from Brazil.
Ah, from Brazil.
I see. Okay, so the social norms in Brazil are very conservative. Is that true?
Oh, definitely. Yes, they are. And I remember when I was 19 years old and I was still virgin, and I was talking to my parents, and I said, "Don't even think about it." You know, but of course, you grow up, go to another country, you learn some different things.
Oh boy.
But that was a disaster for my parents.
And you were a virgin at 19?
Yes, I was.
And at what age did you lose your virginity?
19 and a half.
Oh, boy.
That's not bad. How old are you now?
I'm 42.
And are you pregnant?
Oh, no, I don't. No. I don't want any kids.
How's the look? I mean, the accent's kind of sweet. How's the look? I mean, at 42.
The look is pretty good. You know, I'm in pretty good shape, you know, having the skin that I have and, you know, being Brazilian. How can you beat that?
Yeah. Are you tall?
All right, man.
Pardon?
Are you tall?
I am 5'8".
Yeah, Brazilian chicks are always tall.
Yeah, that's tall. Oh, my gosh. And what do you weigh?
I am 135, actually.
That's perfect.
Yeah, you're doing fine. You're doing fine. How's the neck? You don't have the gobbler or anything, do you?
Oh, no. Please, if I start having those things, I'll go straight to the plastic surgeon. No way.
All right, baby. We thank you for calling.
Thank you.
All right. You take care of yourself. There she goes.
She sounded kind of sexy.
Yeah, she sounded like she was enjoying herself.
Yeah, she's Brazilian, man.
Kyle in Los Angeles, you're on 97.1 Free FM. Jamie Lynn Spears, 16-year-old sister of Britney Spears, is pregnant. What say you, counselor?
Yeah, I just wanted to clear something up. It doesn't matter. It's irrelevant whether or not the male is over the age of majority, 18, they could still be prosecuted for statutory rape. It's a strict liability crime.
Right, but are you an attorney, sir?
Absolutely. Yeah.
Isn't it true though that more often than not, if both parties are underage, if it's two 16-year-olds, two 15-year-olds consenting to sexual activity, there's usually not a prosecution there. But when the female is underage and the male is overage, it's much more likely for there to be a prosecution of a crime there. Am I right about that?
Well, what usually is the reason is the parent of the female would push for prosecution.
I see.
And so you're probably right in majority, if you're looking at majority of situations.
Yeah, but the mother doesn't have to pursue it. The state of California can.
Well, you're right, but they won't pursue it if they don't. Even though it's a strict liability crime, meaning there's no intent needed, as long as there was sexual intercourse, period, end of story. But the point is that they will not normally prosecute if they're not going to get the cooperation
from
the alleged victim.
Well, but I think in this case, if this is true, Casey guy is 19 and she's 16. Tim is right. The state can go ahead and do that. And the state is, in my experience, and this just from reading the newspaper, the state is more inclined when one is under the age of consent, is specifically a female, and one is above the age, specifically a male. I think Tim's right about that. Oftentimes, the state will say, "I don't care what the parents want. We're going after this guy."
Going by the scenario you asked about being underage, but if assuming he is older, you're correct. They will be more apt to go after him.
Oh, boy.
Now, the problem there might be is if they decide to get married, and in the meantime, that could also cause problems. They could still prosecute, but it could also cause problems.
All right, buddy. We thank you for calling, but it's going to be terrible for Jamie Lynn Spears' kid.
Mm-hmm.
If the father's prosecuted and the father goes to jail.
Right.
And, you know, the picture of the baby being born and the subsequent pictures of the baby growing up or the first couple of years of the baby's life.
Right.
And there's no father in any of the pictures.
Right.
The kid eventually will say when she's like 10 or 11, "Why isn't dad in any of those pictures?" Well, sit down, baby.
Okay.
He was convicted of rape.
Of who?
Yeah, who did he rape? And then she's got to say, you know, moi, and you're the result of it.
Right. So maybe the state, given that scenario, you know, since they're keeping the baby, and obviously it seems that they'll stay
not
together.
A mess.
Maybe the state in that scenario declines to prosecute for the sake of the baby.
But what is that? What signal does that send other 19-year-old men? As long as your rape is successful and you impregnate her
and marry,
hands off.
Well, that's a good point. You raise a good
point.
Yeah.
So I don't know. It is a complete mess. But white trash behavior, it's always interesting,
especially at the holiday time. I mean, really, you know, it's really. It's kind of refreshing. There's kind of a warmth to it. It's like a cup of eggnog.
Chris in Burbank, you're on 97.1 Free FM.
Hey, look at you, dude.
Hey,
man, look at you, man. Everybody in Burbank is talking about Chris the stud, man.
How are you guys doing, man?
Good. What do you got?
Good.
Okay, well, basically, I just want to basically tell you that this is really nothing out of the ordinary, because my sister, she actually had a friend who was 15, and she ended up getting knocked up by some Guatemalan immigrant, like illegal immigrant, and he was obviously older. And they went ahead and actually they're married now and have two kids of their own. And I'm just saying what happens with Britney Spears' sister, it's not really anything out of the ordinary.
Well, but I don't know where you grew up, but it is to me.
Oh, okay. Well, I grew up here in Burbank, and this, I mean, it happens.
Yeah, I grew up near Burbank, too, and I bet the majority of the people in Burbank think it's odd and it's wrong.
Yeah, and I mean, if you're going to, you've used the term out of the ordinary, it is.
It's out of the ordinary.
Right, it's not ordinary for this to happen. It's not typical for this to happen.
Right, but I just think that it's under the media microscope, and I think that because everyone sees it publicly, it really people don't realize that it is actually happening in their backyards or where they live.
Yeah, I know, but there still is shame attached to it. For the parents.
But what I'm saying is that since they're very financially well off, her kid can very well grow up and, you know, she can still have a life and go to college. And
right, but Chris, I'm sorry, Tim, go ahead.
No, good.
I was just going to say, haven't we learned, you say they're financially well off, haven't we learned that that all of the money in the world does not safeguard these people, and I'm referring to the Spears and the Lohans and the Paris Hiltons, all of this money does not safeguard them from destructive behavior or out of the ordinary behavior or sleazy behavior.
Right. Yeah, no, I totally agree with that, but they do have much more options, a lot more, you know, they can do a lot more than just, you know, being that destructive behavior. I mean, they have the power, really, to...
Yeah, but also it sends a wrong signal to the other kids watching Nickelodeon.
Yeah,
it's the reason why they're banning all kinds of steroids in Major League Baseball.
Mm-hmm.
It's not because they care about the health of Major League Baseball players. They don't really care one way or another. They just don't want this to become an epidemic where the kids start doing it.
An entire generation.
Right.
Right.
And has to do it to compete. So they want to try to kill the steroid deal now. Hey, listen, if it was up to Major League Baseball, every one of the players would be on steroids, mm-hmm. because you want to see a guy who is bigger than life, stronger than you, hit a home run and hit the ball about 600 feet.
And sell more tickets that way.
Yeah.
Right.
You want to see a guy like, Barry Bonds, you know, hit, 700 and, 50 some odd home runs?
Right, whatever he's up to, where he finished at.
But that's what people go to see. But the reason why they don't is it sends the wrong signal to kids. It really does.
So you think Nickelodeon's going to fire her?
I don't think Nickelodeon is thrilled with this.
Oh, I'm sure they're not thrilled with
it.
And
I don't think they can fire because they're in a bad position. If they fire her, then they'll say, you know, that's a bad sign also to kids. You know, if you get pregnant,
and you keep
don't
your
tell anybody.
Oh, that's true, too. Right. You keep your baby, we fire you.
Yeah. So all of a sudden kids are having abortions in, you know, like public bathrooms because they're afraid to tell anybody.
Right. Yeah, you're right. I guess Nickelodeon
tough. Everybody's in a bad position.
It makes me think now that Nickelodeon will not fire. They will not fire.
I don't think they will. Yeah, I don't think they will. But they're not happy about it at all. That's not the way. My kid watches Nickelodeon all the time, Nick Jr. And this is not the type of thing that you can show kids and get them involved with, and it sucks for everybody. Everybody loses here, including that kid. That kid has got no shot.
The baby?
The baby's got no chance.
Well, I hate to say that.
Got a crazy effing family. Crazy, 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 crazy. All right, it's Conway and Whitman live at 97.1 Free FM. Welcome back, everybody. It is the Conway and Whitman Show, and we're live on 97.1 Free FM.
Yeah, man.
Britney Spears' younger sister, Jamie Lynn Spears, she's 16 and pregnant. She's that the star of that Zoe 101.
Now, I have not seen that show. Does your daughter watch her, Zoe?
Nah, my daughter's 2 years and 2 months. She's still into Dora and Diego and the Backyardigans, the Wonder Pets.
You know who watches Zoe is my buddy back east, whose daughter is, she's six, and she watches a High School Musical, and that's what, I'm confusing your daughter with his daughter. She watches Zoe. She loves her.
All right, pregnant and 16. Walter in Montebello, you're on 97.1 Free FM.
Hey, look at these studs, man.
Yeah, man.
Okay, he's, I mean,
is it raining out there?
Prime.
It was earlier.
Yeah.
We are two prime studs here for you.
Yeah, man.
What do you got?
Hey, I heard actually 2 months ago she was pregnant from a friend that goes to school with that guy.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
Now, is he a big stud? What's his deal?
I don't know, man. I heard that she's pretty loose, too.
Well, I haven't heard that. I mean, that's you saying that. I guess, you know, if she's 16 and pregnant, she can't be a prude.
I mean, she can't be like, no way, I would never. She can't be that girl, right?
No, she's not that girl.
She's well, I mean, yeah, okay.
I'm not sure if she's the girl that, you know, points to her crotch and says, you want a piece. But I'm not sure that she's also... the girl who says no to everybody.
Well, she clearly does. I mean, we know for a fact, based on these reports, that she does not say no to everybody.
She's a whore! Sure. Is she closer to this girl? Hey.
You want a piece?
A piece of that?
I don't know. I'd have to meet her personally to make a determination.
I don't know. I don't know her well at all.
I kind of hope she is. No, I don't. You know what I want? I want 16-year-olds to be wholesome. But you know what the amazing thing is? Here's the amazing thing. Like, I am 35, and I am not a dad.
I wonder if they have to hire an obstetrician who's under 18.
You mean over 18?
Under 18.
Oh. I don't think there are any.
No.
Like a Doogie Howser obstetrician?
Right.
No, I don't think so.
Whoever delivers that baby has to be under 18, or else that... That's having...
Yeah, right. You know, well, no, it's clinical. They have medical
it's
license.
Touching a...
No. It's a doctor, Tim, please. My buddy back in New York, you know, my best friend, he is my age. We're both 35, but he's further along in life than I am. He's married with two kids, and he has a daughter and a son, the daughter I mentioned a moment ago. I was talking to him about...
How old are his kids?
His daughter is six.
Right.
And his son is three.
Is she pregnant?
No, she's not pregnant. And we were talking. The conversation turned to like some 18-year-old or some like 19-year-old. And I was on the phone going, oh, gosh, I'm so hot. I think it was that girl from High School Musical. You know, I'm going, oh, my gosh. And he's like, yeah, I'm not really into that, you know. I said, what?
Yeah, when you got kids.
Yeah, and then we got into this whole conversation where he revealed to me, he said, well, you know, since I have a daughter now, it's like, he said, to be honest with you, Bri, he said, I couldn't get it on with an 18-year-old girl.
Yeah.
I said, are you kidding me?
He might be lacking in testosterone, too.
But I said, what happened to you? He said, well, I have a daughter. I mean, when I see teenage girls, I think of my daughter now.
Yeah, because you see your teenage, you know, kids going to like, you know, Hannah Montana, and it takes the sexuality out a lot.
But I feel like I lost.
Because 18-year-old, you know, girls sometimes they look like they're 16 or 17, and you takes that out of them.
But you know, I feel like I lost my friend. Kind of.
Get out of here! What's wrong with you? All right, it is the Conway and Whitman Show. When we come back, we got the news plus a guy who's a hypnotist.
Yeah, this guy is a
coming in tonight right after
stud.
The news, and then at 10 o'clock. Mr. Traffic's coming in. Is that right?
We have a busy night. Is Reed Berry the
traffic guy?
Oh, don't call him Mr. Traffic.
Why?
Because there's another guy who calls himself Mr. Traffic.
Well, then guess what, Reed? If you don't like being called Mr. Traffic, then don't call yourself Traffic Guy at all.
No. Here's the thing.
Don't have one guy Mr. Traffic and the other guy Mrs. Traffic.
No, Tim. The Traffic Guy and Mr. Traffic.
All right, well, you can see how I could screw that up.
Okay, I understand that, but I want you to know that they were...
They don't like each other?
I think they were in business together at one point.
I can't concern myself with that. I have no space left in my mind to concern myself over the relationship that Mr. Traffic and the traffic guy have.
Can I just ask you then, since he's going to be a guest on our show, to make sure you don't call him Mr. Traffic?
I will try not to, but if it slips out and he walks off, I don't give a rat's ass.
Just call him. You want me to write down the traffic guy and put it in front of you?
You know what? Let's call him by his real name then. What's his real name?
Reed.
Reed. No traffic in his name.
You don't have to get upset. I'm just trying to make
I'm tired of that crap. Mr. Traffic and the traffic guy don't get along.
Well, they don't. It's
why? Because they both have the same lame act. Is that why they don't get along?
Don't you yell at me. When he gets here, you ask him.
All right. It's Conway and Whitman live on 97.1 Free FM.
Jesus Christ.